हेलो स्कॉलर्स, वेलकम बैक। वेयर वर वी? वी वर इन द डेजर्ट, राइट, विद द मर्चेंट एंड द जिनी, राइट। चैप्टर 9 फ्रॉम आर स्टूडेंट्स बुक। एंड वी फिनिश्ड दिस स्टोरी टिल विच पार्ट? व्हेन जिनी वॉज वेरी एंग्री ऑन द मर्चेंट, बिकॉज जिनी वॉज ब्लेमिंग टू द मर्चेंट दैट मर्चेंट हैड killed the genie's son, and now genie is not in mood to leave the merchant. He is in mood to kill the merchant, right? So from there we will start today. Let's move ahead. Oh genie, pray allow me to return home. I must finish the task I have left undone. I will return at the beginning of the new year. So now what the merchant is saying, merchant is asking that please genie, please allow me, let me go to my home, and if you want to kill me, let me go and finish my work. I have so many undone work, I left so many works at my place. So I will go, I will finish each and every work, and at the beginning of the new year I will return here, so at that time you can kill me. Thou you may then kill me, begged the merchant, hoping that the genie would have mercy on him. So what he was thinking, that if I will say such things, and if maybe by saying these things genie can get trust on me, so he may leave me, so that I can go to my city. He was thinking like that. Who? The merchant, because the merchant was very kind man, right? So what he is asking, permission, so that he can go to his place. Let me go to the city to meet my family for the last time. I will clear all my debts and dues, arrange some money for my family's future life, and give alms to the poor, so that I get a seat in heaven after my death. So what, so many works he had. What he was saying, that let me go to my place, so that I can clear all my debts and dues, because he was a businessman, right? Merchant was he had some business, and he had some debts and dues. He has taken some money, or he given some money to some people, so he has to clear each and everything. He has to arrange money for his family, he want to meet to his family for the last time. And what he said in last, that he has to give alms to the poor, so that he can get seat in heaven after the death. So he is thinking about himself also, that if I will give alms to the poor, alms means jo hum daan dete na, like that. So he can give alms to the poor, so that he can get seat in the heaven after his death. So he was asking permission from the genie. The genie let him go. The merchant returned to his own city and transacted his business. Okay, so what happened? Genie allowed him. Genie said, okay, you go, and at the beginning of the new year you have to come back here. Okay, so genie allowed him to go. The merchant came to his own city and transacted his business. Whatever debts and dues were there, he cleared each and everything. He was arranging money for his family. Whatever he promised there with genie, he was trying to finish all that works. Okay, after informing his wife and children of what had happened to him, he appointed a guardian for them. Okay, so what happened? He told each and everything about the incident. He told to his family, his wife, and he appointed one guardian for them. Okay, means who can take care of his family, like that. So when the new year began, the merchant bid a tearful farewell to his people, his neighbors, and all his kith and kin, and left. So what happened at the time of New Year? What he did? He bid a tearful farewell. Farewell means he informed to his kith and kins. He informed his dear and near ones. He called each and everyone. He told the incident to each and everyone, and he took farewell from them. So that now he can go to meet the genie. okay. So after the new year, he left from his city. He traveled until he arrived at the oasis. As he sat weeping, a very old man came near, leading a gazelle. Okay, so lastly he reached to the same place, to the oasis, where he met to the genie before. Last time where he met to the genie, he came to the same place, and he was he sat under the palm tree and he was weeping, he was crying. Okay, so at the same time what happened, a very old man came near, and that old man had a gazelle, a small deer with him. Okay, gazelle is a synonym of small deer. Okay, so that old man came to him and he asked that, why you are crying here? This place is not good. This place is haunted of evil spirits. Haunted of evil spirits means evil spirits are frequently coming to this place. That's why this place is not good. Why you are here and why you are crying? Why you are alone here? Who asked? The old man who came with one small deer to the merchant. Okay. The merchant told the man his story, hearing which the old man said, "Oh brother, thy story is strange. It is warning to all." Then sitting near the merchant, he said, "I will not leave thee." Okay, so what the old man said, that the merchant told each and everything, a whole incident to that old man. And after hearing his story, the old man said that, "Oh my brother, it's very strange, such things, whatever happened with you, that incident is very strange, and it's warning for each and everyone, for all. Why? Because if such things happen, then it's very difficult to cross this area," right? He said that. So he sat beside him and said that, "I am not going to leave you here alone. I will sit with you." As they were waiting for genie, okay, they both sat there under the palm tree and they were waiting for the genie. A second old man approached them, and with him were two black dogs. The second old man, after saluting them, also asked them, "What makes thee sit in this place, a home of the spirits?" Okay, now the second old man came and he had two black dogs with him. Okay, he had two black dogs. First one had one small deer. He has two black dogs. Okay, so he saluted them. Saluted them means in respect of others, when we are greeting others like that. Okay, he saluted them and asked, "What makes you sit in this place? This place is home of evil spirits. So why you both are sitting here?" He also asked the same question which was asked by the first old man. So they told him the tale. As they were talking, a third old man with a mule arrived. He saluted them and asked them why they were seated here. So they told him the told tale. He sat down with them. Okay, when they were telling the whole story to the second old man, the man who came with two black dogs, at the same time third old man came with one mule. Mule is just like donkey. Okay, so third old man came and he asked the same question, that why you three are here, this place is not good. Okay, so they told the same story to the third old man. So now what happened, they all four were under the palm tree. They were there discussing about the incident. Lo and behold, a dust cloud appeared and the mighty genie appeared with a drawn sword in his hand. His eyes were full of rage. He came up to them and, taking away the merchant from among them, said to him, "Arise, that I may kill thee, as thou killed my son." Okay, when they were waiting they were there under the palm tree, at the same time what happened, a cloud appeared and the genie came out from that cloud, and he had sword in his hand and he was aggressive, very aggressive. His eyes were full of rage, means full of rage. He want to take revenge from the merchant. He want to kill the merchant because he was on the thinking that the merchant had killed his son. Okay, so he took the merchant from there, from out of that four people, he took the merchant from there and said that I will kill you. The merchant wept and the three old men began crying. Okay, so merchant started, he was weeping, merchant was crying, and the same time the three old men, they also started crying. Then the first old man came out from among them and kissed the hand of the genie and said, "Oh genie, if were to tell thee my story and that of my gazelle, and if you find it wonderful, would you spare a third of this merchant's life?" Okay, so now what happened? The first old man who came to the merchant, the first old man who came with gazelle, with one small deer, that old man came out among them and he kissed at the hand of the genie and said that, "Oh genie, I want to tell you one story about my small deer, about my gazelle, and if you find it wonderful, then would you spare a third of this merchant's life?" After listening that story, if you find that this story is wonderful, this story is marvelous, so will you leave this merchant's life? So he asked question from the genie. Then said the genie, "Old man, if thou tell me this tale and I find it a marvelous, then I will spare a third of merchant's life." Okay, so what he said, genie agreed with the old man offer, that if your story will be marvelous, if I like your story, then I will leave, I will spare the merchant's life. Who said? Genie said. He agreed on the old man's offer. Okay, thereupon the old man with the gazelle began to speak. Okay, and after that the first old man started telling one story with his small deer, and in this way genie left the he forgave the life of merchant. He forgave the merchant and he leave merchant, he doesn't kill him. Okay, so in this way this story is finished here. And what is your task now? You have to learn the word meanings which is given on page number 99, and at the same time you have to try to make sentence by the words given on page number 99. Same words which are given as a word meaning, by the same words you have to try to make sentence in your own words. Okay, and in next video we will start something new. Till that time, take care. Bye bye.